The US military is operating many types of helicopters, but this is expensive. Some of them, like the Chinook heavy lift helicopter, have been around for a very long time and have been extremely successful. Others, like the Apache attack helicopter, are symbols of the Army's power. Still others, like the Black Hawk, are internationally acclaimed and remind us of the famous movie Black Hawk Down. But all of these and more are beginning to show their age. Consequently, a replacement for the future vertical lift is being developed to replace many of these rotary-wing aircraft with one very ambitious platform. The design requirements for this new helicopter are extremely demanding and are pushing the limits of modern engineering. The Army is considering multiple designs, including a tilt-rotor helicopter like the iconic V-22 Osprey. Here are surprising facts about the future vertical lift, the replacement for the legendary Chinook and Apache helicopters. Scope of replacement. It seems that the military hasn't been discouraged by the shockingly expensive F-35 fighter program that sought a single platform to replace several airframes all at once. The future vertical lift is being planned to replace the UH-60 Black Hawk, AH-64 Apache, CH-47 Chinook, and OH-58 Kyo helicopters. Additionally, to these four types of the Army's helicopters, the Navy is also a partner in the program, and it may also replace the Navy's MH-60 helicopters. We will see if they manage to design a helicopter airframe that can fulfill all these roles. It's ambitious, for sure. War on Terror accelerated the need. The Army's involvement in Operation Iraqi Freedom and the subsequent Operation Enduring Freedom had the effect of wearing out the Army's helicopters faster. During combat operations, helicopters typically fly 5 times more often than during peacetime. For a long time now, the focus has been on upgrading the existing families of Blackhawks, Chinooks, etc. of helicopters without creating new platforms. With the future vertical lift that is set to radically change, some of these designs are getting old, so the Army wants to start with a clean slate. This has worked in the past with the F-18 Hornet. The aim. The aim of the future vertical lift is to create an all-new rotor craft that incorporates all the latest technology. It aims to be able to have a quicker design timetable and to use new materials. Upgrading older models is cheaper and has less risk, but one problem is that it is inherently working with an old design that doesn't take advantage of new innovations. With an all-new design, it is intended to boast better ranges, heavier payloads, as well as to be more reliable and easier to maintain. It is planned to have lower operating costs than today's helicopters. Design requirements. The requirements are not yet fully settled and placed in stone, as they are still being refined. However, broad notions of its requirements demand a top speed of 260 miles per hour, capacity for up to 12 troops, to have a combat radius of at least 263 miles, and an overall range without refueling of 527 or so miles. Valor versus Defiant. The V-280 Valor is a tilt-rotor aircraft that was unveiled in 2012 and made its first flight in December 2017 in Texas. It is currently undergoing flight testing and development. Boeing and Sikorsky's SB Defiant is a compound helicopter with rigid coaxial rotors and had its first test flight in March 2019. They are currently working on developing a medium-sized demonstrator. According to some industry experts, the Boeing Sikorsky design is seen to have the advantage over Bell's design. Given the expected time frame, when the Army is expecting the first to enter service, it won't be long until there's a winner. In summary, the future vertical lift is a very ambitious program, and it may prove to be revolutionary in helicopter design.